Hi everyone, my name is Fabian. I'm a fellow at the Django CMS Association. In this screencast, we're diving into Django CMS Frontend 2.1 and its new component-first approach. This update simplifies building flexible, reusable UI components with Django CMS. Let's take a look. Previously, Django CMS Frontend was tightly integrated with Bootstrap, which it still fully supports, of course. However, since version 2, Django CMS Frontend introduces a component-first approach, enabling standalone reusable components across the site, easier content editing by allowing inline editing for components, and improved maintainability and development efficiency. Let's set up a project and see it in action. We start by creating a Django CMS project. Here's how. I have already created a virtual environment. I start a new Django CMS project. And I will go into the project folder. Now here I initialize a new app, which I will call theme, where I can organize components. Inside the theme app, I will be creating some directories for templates. And the components we want to create. Now I will also have to update the settings. I will add the new theme app to the settings. I will be removing all pre-built plugins of Django CMS Frontend. And for the time being, I'll be moving Django CMS Frontend just before Django CMS Text. Now let's start the development server and see what we've got. I will have to log in first. And I can create a first page, just as with any new Django CMS project. Instead of using Bootstrap, we'll be building components using Tailwind CSS for this demonstration. So the first thing I will do is modify the base template, remove the Bootstrap dependencies, and use the minimal template from the Django CMS documentation. All I've done here is I have added Tailwind CSS from a CDN. Now let's create a button component. First, I create a new file called button.html. Then I will go to the Tailwind UI and select a button component. I just copy the code of a simple one. Let's take this one here. And add it to our new template. To make a component out of this, I have to realize this is a Django template, so I can load template tags. I'll load the front end tags and the CMS component tag and start declaring a component, which I call button. I also add the name so I can translate it later. And for this component, this button will render. Let's save this and check it out on the development server. Now the page is empty, not added anything, but see here, now I have a new button component, which is called button, and there is nothing to do there, so I can just add it, and it gives me exactly the template I've been copying. But that's not what we want. We would like to customize this component, of course. So I start, continue by declaring a field, two fields actually. The title of the button, which is a char field. And maybe a link the button should lead to. Links are provided by a different package, Django CMS link, which defines a link form field. And to use it, I also need the link tags. It's going to be a link. We also have a reference. And here I can use the just declared fields. So I can use the link field and add the to URL tag, which I would have to do for Django CMS link, and I could replace button text by title. So that's all I've done. Now, when changing the declaration of a component, I would need to restart the server. Then I can open my button and change the text, internal link, go to my only page, and there it goes. The button has changed. Now let's build a more complex component, a call to action. Again, I go to pick some template. And let's see. Let's take this one. It's a simple HTML template. I copy it. I call it cta.html, the file. And let's just insert the just copied CSS here. And again, I can just make a declaration. And say this is going to be a CMS component. Let's call this CTA. And again, we can have some fields. We have a title field. And that's going to be this one here. And we actually make it an H1 to be nicer. So that's going to be the title field. A subtitle field, which we also will have to declare. So now we have a body, but the body can be rich text, so we have a different field. We call it, we use HTML form field for this. It's also required. And with many of those components, we see that code has classes added to the, let's say, to the paragraphs here. We turn this into a div and let the HTML form field add any paragraphs, etc. So since this is going to be formatted, I would have to do auto escape off here and add the body and do auto escape on and take out the original part. And then there's this area we can add buttons, but we already declared a button, so I'm not going to repeat all this. I just will delete what's already in there and allow the editors to add child plugins, for example, a button. At this place here. So that's my component. I will save it. I will go back, restart the server. Oh, and obviously, I have to correct a mistake and auto escape here. So, and start the server again. And now let's go to our page. And there's the call to action. I can add it. I can add save it. And there's the component we just created. The button is missing though, but now since we have allowed child plugins, we can just move the button down here, and there it is. Now, this is not the end of the story. I would like to make this more comfortable for the editors and add inline editing. This is very simple. I replace the variable expansion, the context expansion here, by an inline tag, which is inline field, subtitle, please here. Inline field title here, and let's spell this correctly. And also let's make the body an inline field. So this also requires restart of the server. And then let me reload this. I still have to turn off auto escape. I can do this actually by adding the instance of the component. I keep the language and add a save. There we go. And I can now edit inline all the fields of this plugin. This is all fine. The only thing that's missing now is an image, which I can configure. But that's also no problem. Again, let me go to the template and add another field. Let's call the CTM image, and this is an image form field, which is also required then. And now I can use this. First, I have to actually fetch the image, and then I can use the image's URL here. Or its old value. That's all I need to have a customized image. Let's check this out. Again, with a changing declaration, we need to restart the server. There I can add the CTA image. Now I have not got one, so I will need to upload an image. Let's take this one. And there it is. Now the other one was a little bluish. Again, let's just change the template. Make this grayscale. And we do not need to restart the server. There we go. With Django CMS Frontend 2.1, developers can now build independent reusable components, even by writing template code only. They can improve editor experiences, allowing inline editing, and then can reduce reliance on deeply nested structures or other ways we could traditionally create these types of complicated components. This approach simplifies development and enhances maintainability. Also, it saves a lot of time. Thanks for watching and happy coding!